Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to do a tag video and I just got tagged by Stephanie and Amanda to do this my makeup style tag, and I think just as they said, let's bring back the tag videos because it's just so much fun to get to know each other on a personal level and just in a different way than just the panning videos and the get ready with me's. So this is so fun and I really really like this tag. So there are 10 questions, kind of. So let's just get started. And the first question is, what kind of eye primer do you use and why? Liquid primer or shadow stick? I have very oily eyelids and therefore I can't use like just a cream shadow as my primer. So I'm using at the moment my Urban Decay primer potion here. And I set that with a cream white shadow, what I'm just panning at the moment. And then I put a cream shadow on top, because if I just use a cream shadow, it is creasing and caking up throughout the day and just ruining my eyeshadow, and I don't want that. So I always use eyelid primer, no matter what. The second question is split up into two. So 2A is, what color eyeshadow makes you feel bold and pretty at the same time? I love, love, love the copper and orange eyeshadows. I think they are bold and they are so pretty at the same time, and I just feel awesome in orange eyeshadow in general. So I just think they are amazing. What eyeshadow color do you least like to wear and why? I like all kind of eyeshadow and I like all kind of colors, but the colors I don't wear as much is the blue and the green shadows. I can pull off like these like teal colors right here paired with some orange eyeshadow or something. I can wear the blue, but I don't use it as much as I do with the purples and the orange and the very neutral shadows. Number three is, do you wear liquid or pencil eyeliner? I mostly wear liquid liner. That is my preferred eyeliner type. At the moment I'm panning this P2 eyeliner, this burgundy shade. It's so pretty, but it's just the hassle to sharpen things. I'm just so lazy with that. So I don't really like pencil eyeliner, so I really want to get through those you have to sharpen this year. I mostly use liquid liner that is black. I have some fun colors I got for Christmas and my birthday, so I'm going to play with those a lot this year. Yeah, that is also the next question, black or brown liner. I prefer my black liners, I really do. The brown ones, I have one brown liner that I really really love though, but I prefer my black ones. Number four, Covergirl or Maybelline mascara? Come on, you know you're one way or the other. If you don't know, I live in Denmark, so we don't have Covergirl over here, but I have heard Covergirl is very very similar to Max Factor that we do have here in Europe, and I love Max Factor as a brand. The lipsticks is amazing. I have used one or two of their mascaras. I didn't really like them, so I'm 100% a Maybelline mascara girl because I love the Less Sensational, the pink one. And that is one of my top favorite mascaras, and the Maybelline the Rugged is also one of my favorites. So I'm for sure a Maybelline girl. So number five, if you could have your brows permanently done or not wear any blush for the rest of your life, which would you choose? I would definitely do the permanently brow thingy, because it's just such a hassle to do your brows, and I'm still in the learning process to do my brows. I'm experimenting a lot with my brows. They have gone through a lot over the years. I'm only 23, but I have done a lot to my brows, but I'm still learning the shape and how to do them and the products for my brows and stuff like that. So I will definitely just get them permanently done and then change up my blush, because I really really enjoy blush. So I will rather just have my brows done. Number six, does your best friend or you wear more makeup? Just like Stephanie, I don't really have a best friend. I have a lot of best girlfriends in my life. I'm so lucky. And they all kind of wear makeup, and they wear makeup on a different level. One of my bestest girlfriend from boarding school, she wears just as much makeup as me. I think I take longer to do my makeup than her, definitely. But all my other girlfriends, they don't really use makeup, that much makeup, or use makeup on a regular basis as me, as I do. So I think I'm the one who takes the longest and use the most makeup in my group of friends. But here on YouTube, I'm definitely at the same level as some girls. So I feel fine. I'm just a makeup addict, and I would love to do my makeup. That is one thing I prioritize in my morning, and I always set at least a half an hour or 45 minutes to it, because I just need to relax during it. I don't like to rush to do my makeup. It's just not me. Number 7. Who taught you to do makeup? I started doing my makeup in like 6th grade or something. I was allowed to use mascara, and I just used a mascara my mom bought me. And then I moved on to eyeliner, a lot of eyeliner. And then later I moved on to powder, and I just smacked it on. I didn't know how to do it. I didn't do a brows until like senior year in like high school. So yeah, I just smashed some on, and then I just learned in the process to do it. In boarding school, my best friend, one of my bestest friends from high boarding school, she introduced me to YouTube. That's where I became addicted to YouTube, because I watched a lot of YouTubers, how they did it, and I just kind of copied in the first years of how to do it, and I learned what makeup was good and what was not, and I realized most of my makeup was not that good. It was not that good quality. So that is also where I discovered project panning and used up my bad stuff first. And one of my first like proper palettes I bought is my Too Faced Juggler Bar. So I splurged a lot. I didn't have that much money, but the palettes I had at the time was not that good. So that was my first really good palette, and then further on, I just discovered the love for eyeshadow. So I think I'm self-taught, and then my girlfriends and me, we just exchanged experience. And so my mom introduced me to a mascara first, but she didn't tell me how to do it, because I still do her makeup, so. So I really don't know. I think I'm self-taught. And my battery is dying. Perfect. So number 8. Are you a fan of cream products, blush, bronzer, contour, etc.? Why or why not? I don't like cream blush. I don't like cream bronzer. I don't like cream contour. I have a palette that is a cream contour and highlight palette from W7 that I actually really like. But that is the only cream contour I will ever have in my collection, because I have had a cream bronzer before, and cream blush, I used that up, but I don't like it. Number 9, are you a project panner? What projects are you in right now? If you are a follower of me on my Danish channel and my English channel, you would have known I have panned in a really long time. So yes, I'm a project panner. I call myself a project panner because I am in a lot of projects, and I'm addicted to project panning. I think it's so much fun to get use out of your collection and your products and get your money's worth, and just experience the process of panning a palette and stuff like that, because I have done panner palette for like 3-4 years now. Yeah, this is my fourth year panning a palette, so that's quite, that's actually insane to think about. What projects are you in right now? I am doing a lip service, I'm doing a full face project pan, I'm doing a panda palette, I'm doing an Finish 8 by Women's Day with a bunch of ladies. I'm doing a project polish. I think that's it for now. That's a lot, oh my god. But some of them are year-long project pans. So if you are interested in a lot of panning projects and collabs with a bunch of lovely ladies, I would suggest check out the Pantastic Ladies group that Amanda and Jessica have created, because it's just amazing. We are over 400 members now, and there are tons of projects. I don't even know all of them. So many. There's so many. Number 10, setting spray. Do you believe in it? Which is your holy grail? I don't know if I believe in it. I kind of do. I haven't seen the most difference in my makeup, but I have it. I always have one in hand because sometimes a shadow just needs the help that a cream shadow can't give it. Right now I'm just using the W7 the Matte Fixer face spray. I definitely forget to use it, so I don't want to spend a lot of money on a setting spray. I have always wanted to try the Urban Decay sprayer or the Fix Plus by MAC, but I just can't tell myself to buy that because I don't use it regularly. I just don't use it enough to say, oh, you should buy that. I don't think I believe in it, but at the same time, I do. I use it when I remember to. I think that's everything. Oh my god. Stephanie has tagged a lot of people. I will try to tag some that I can't see on her list or Amanda's list. And some others have done this as well. So I will try to tag some people that is in my mind not tagged yet.